The BMW 335i comes with a factory intercooler, but it's small in size and is known to heat soak under heavy load. This is rather inconvenient for those that run the car hard on the track and don't want to run the risk of the vehicle going into limp mode. By installing a MAPerformance BMW 335 oil cooler, you eliminate the risk of heat soak, even with increased boost pressure and engine stress. Let's get started with the install. You're going to be removing the front bumper, modifying the factory air dam, and installing a distribution block on the factory oil cooler sending unit. From the distribution block, you run the new cooler lines to the cooler unit located behind the bumper. First, lift the vehicle. Drain the oil by removing the oil plug on the oil pan. Allow as much oil as possible to drain to reduce the mess created later by removing the factory cooler lines. Once the oil has completely drained, replace the plug and begin removing the front bumper. The first step in removing the bumper is to remove the 3 8mm screws attaching the fender liner to the bumper. With these removed, gently peel back the liner and remove the 2 8mm screws that attach the bumper to the front fender. After that, remove the under paneling attachment screws. They are 8mm. Then remove the T30 Torx bolts on top of the bumper that attach to the core support. The last step in removing the front bumper is to disconnect the headlight washer covers, and this can be tricky. We had the best luck using an interior trim tool and pick, but you can use whatever is easiest and won't damage your paint. Gently pry out the cover and press down on the springs with the pick. The cover should come off, and you can gently pry off the retainer clip after that. With the bumper off your car, you can remove the air induction pieces. The air intake air dam is held on by 2 T25 bolts and a few body clips. The air dam shroud is surrounded by a core support brace that needs to come off by removing the 3 T30 bolts. Remove this and set the shroud aside. You need to cut this to allow room for your new oil cooler. Attach the banjo fitting to the oil cooler's lower fitting. Make sure to use Teflon tape or liquid Teflon on all fitting threads. Now you may install the oil cooler on the car. Start by attaching the top and lower brackets to the oil cooler. You'll be using the 2 forwardmost outer holes on top of the core support to mount the cooler. With the oil cooler centered, it should line up perfectly. You may then attach the lower brackets to the lower core support using the supplied hardware. With the oil cooler mounted to the car, it's time to start running the lines. To do this, we need to remove the factory fan. Start by unplugging the wiring harness, then remove the 1 T25 bolt. Gently lift the pan up and out of its mounting holes and set aside. Remove the factory oil cooler lines from the sender by removing the T30 bolt. Let the lines drain as much oil as possible. Take the supplied oil distribution block, insert the supplied O-rings, and install on the sender unit with factory oil lines on the bottom, in the same orientation as they were removed. Tighten the securing bolt. Next, move on to your new oil cooler lines. Begin by modifying your air dam to allow your new lines to pass through. The easiest way to do this is to take a utility knife and cut an X into the dam. Make the holes large enough for the fittings to pass through, and install it onto the car. The oil return line is the driver's side fitting on the cooler, and requires 44 inches of hose. The feed line is 60 inches and attaches to the lower fitting, where we attach the banjo fitting. Cut and assemble the hoses based on the given dimensions, and install on the car. Tighten all fittings on the oil cooler and the distribution block. With all the fittings tightened and the lines connected, replace your oil filter and fill oil to capacity. Start the car and allow it to warm up while checking for leaks. This will allow the oil to populate the new cooler and all lines. Shut the car down and fill to capacity again. You should expect to add an additional 1 to 1.5 quarts of oil with the additional cooler. If everything checks out and no leaks are present, you may reinstall your bumper and enjoy the benefits of cooler oil. Feel free to contact us with any questions regarding this guide. Thanks for watching, and keep an eye out on our channel for more videos and on the maperformance.com/tech site for written installs similar to this. Now get out on the road and enjoy your freshly cooled BMW 335i.